What happens at 3:33 a.m. in Animal Crossing New Horizons? We're about to find out together here in today's video where I go through your top secrets from Animal Crossing. That's right, our full list today features suggestions from you, the viewer. You see, I made a video a while back that featured my personal top 10 secrets of Animal Crossing, and you guys absolutely loved the video. It's by far my most viewed video to date, and you all sent in a ton of suggestions for other secrets and tips that you found along the way. Now I know, it's hard to surprise some of the Animal Crossing veterans out there, but you never know, there just might be something here today that you haven't heard before. There were certainly suggestions sent in that I had no idea about. So with that, let's dive in. Number 1, Alien Invasion. One of you wrote in on the last video and said I should go near a TV around 3:30 a.m. and then watch what happens when it hits 3:33. Now, before trying this one out, I did a little more research, and it turns out it does have to be performed on Saturday morning for Animal Crossing New Horizons. Not sure if that's how it was in the past Animal Crossing games, but for New Horizons, it does have to be Saturday morning, 3:33 a.m. And so after getting this suggestion, I had to try it out for myself, and well, I was not disappointed. Well, that's not creepy at all. Nope, not creepy at all. Number 2, Demon Dogs. Well, we might as well continue along with the creepy theme here after that first one. For a game as cute and relaxing as Animal Crossing, you'd think any potential pets may be friendly pets. Apparently, not true when it comes to dogs in New Horizons. If you have the doghouse item, which is craftable by the way, then go ahead and try to interact with it by pressing A. Yeah, go ahead, try it right now. You'll be greeted with a pair of demonic red eyes and a vicious growl before it ends just as quickly as it began. Number 3, how to stay in Nook's Cranny after 10 p.m. So even though Nook's Cranny closes at 10 p.m., there are actually a few ways you can hang around after 10 without getting kicked out. The first way is just a funny little Easter egg, but the second way is actually quite practical. You can see here how even though the clock strikes 10 p.m., the Nook boys don't kick me out right away. And it's because I'm using the sit down reaction. I'm not really sure why this is, if this is a glitch or just kind of a, like I said, a funny little Easter egg, but for whatever the reason, the boys don't want to kick you out while you're seated. Unfortunately, this one doesn't serve much of a practical purpose because the moment you stand up, they'll deliver the news that the store is closed and you have to leave. The second way though will actually allow you to continue shopping inside Nooks and you'll need a friend visiting your island. This does not work with local co-op, only with online friends. You'll just need to invite a friend over before the store closes, and then as long as you're both inside Nooks before 10 p.m., you'll be allowed to continue shopping and even selling items. The only way I even found out about this one, guys, is because I hosted a big turnip selling party when I had a really high price. I invited tons of people over to my island to sell. And we were all in there a little bit before 10 o'clock, and then we were trying to keep the store open long enough for one more person to make it inside to sell. Unfortunately, even though they were able to make it in the island and we were inside Nook's Cranny buying and selling after 10, the shop would not let them enter even though the rest of us were still inside. So I'm not sure if this one is actually a glitch or just something weird with how the online works in the game, but whatever the case may be, it allows you and a friend to stay in after 10 p.m. Number 4, tool organization actually matters. Okay, here's another one on our list that actually has a very practical use as you play the game. In the original top 10 video, I mentioned how my 6-year-old son told me you can instantly put away your current tool by pressing down on the D-pad. And if you didn't already know, you can swap between the tools you have in your inventory by pressing left and right on the D-pad. At first, it may seem like this order of the tools is a bit random, but it's actually controlled by the order you have them set in your pockets. So here we can see the order of my tools, and then if I back out of this menu and press right on the D-pad, it goes to the tool that was next in line. Of course, you'll eventually unlock the tool ring for purchase as well, which will enable you to have even more control over selecting different tools. Number 5, Fire-Breathing Godzilla. The monster statue you can purchase through your Nookstop, which does come in different colors by the way, but the only way to collect them all is by trading with others, also has a special interaction function. Okay, maybe it's not that intense, but it does include a nice little fire effect here when you interact with the statue. Number 6, the Able Sisters won't kick you out. So while you can't browse inside Nook's Cranny after closing hours without a friend, the Able Sisters aren't quite so strict with their store hours. In this clip, I enter the store at around 8:59 and browse for a bit. After 1 minute, you hear the town clock tell us it has reached 9 p.m. and the Able Sisters don't react. You can see I continue browsing here and even talk with them, but they make no mention of the closing time whatsoever. So in contrast to Nook's Cranny, as long as you're inside the Able Sisters shop before they close, it seems that you can browse and buy to your heart's content. Number 7, some items affect other items. Here we have yet another fun item interaction, and it involves the air conditioner. My Nook's Cranny store just happened to be selling this recently after I read the comment about this one. Basically, if you have any sort of indoor plant near an air conditioner inside your home, you'll notice it gently blowing in the breeze of your AC. And it actually doesn't have to be right up next to the AC either. You can see here it actually works from a few spaces away and doesn't stop moving until I move it completely out of the way right around here. Number 8, the mantis shrimp wants to be free. While plenty of creatures can be displayed in a lighted tank, and others can even be displayed outside of a tank, the mantis shrimp seems to be not so eager to remain inside his tank. When you press A to interact and turn on or off the light as you normally would with a creature in a tank, you'll also notice the mantis shrimp strikes the glass, leaving a crack across it, which remains for a few seconds. Number 9, another way to fall in a hole. Of all the suggestions that folks wrote in, this one was by far the one I saw the most. You see, in my original video, I talked about some ways that you can fall into a hole, but apparently I didn't cover them all. The one that I missed is how you can also fall into a hole from a seated position. Here's how this one works. You need to be sitting down in something like a chair or maybe on top of a tree stump, and on one side there needs to be a hole. If you attempt to get out of the chair on the same side as the hole, well, there you go, into the hole once again. And before we get to number 10, I just want to say that today's video is brought to you by Audible.com. If you're looking for a new audiobook or podcast, right now you can get a free trial of Audible Plus and 2 free audiobooks using my affiliate link in the video description below. But let's move on to number 10, and looking back at that old video, guys, this right here was one of the most upvoted comments by far, and it just so happens to be both an interesting fact and also very useful to gameplay. It comes to us from YouTube user IDK What I Should Name Myself. Maybe we can help them out with that, commenters. If any of you have anything, throw it out there. But the tip is as follows. Go fishing after it rains for a chance of getting rare fish. So I would even take this a step further and say go fishing while it's raining, because it's ultimately the only way you can catch the elusive coelacanth, which is one of the rarest fish in the whole game. The only way to catch the coelacanth is when it is raining. It's also been a long-held belief that fishing during the rain, or snow for that matter, increases your chances to catch some of the game's harder to find fish. Of course, no matter what the weather is doing, you'll want to first make sure the fish you're after is available during the current month you're playing the game. And this will vary depending on if you're in the Southern Hemisphere or Northern Hemisphere. If you're new to Animal Crossing New Horizons, be sure to check out my full beginner's playlist, which you should see now on the left side of your screen. And if you missed that original Top 10 Secrets video, then hit the link on the right side of your screen. As always, thank you all so much for watching. I'll talk to you again soon.